Hello students, welcome to my online DWPD lecture session. Today we will continue our unit number 1, Introduction to HTML and CSS, and my topic name is HTML table and division tag. Today I am going to discuss about table tag. It is a special tag in HTML table. So we will discuss about table, ke how we will create the table and different attributes of tables. Also we will discuss about the division tag, in which we are using two types of special attributes, IDs and classes and special tags. So let's start with the table tag. Table tag is used to create table in HTML web page. With the table tag, we are using three more tags for creating a table, tr, th and td. tr is stand for table row, th is stand for table heading. That means if we want to specify name of column, then we have to use th, table heading tag. td is stand for table data. We want to pass a cell value, then we have to use td tag. Some more attributes of table tag. First is width, to specify width of a table. Border, if you want to specify table border, then you have to pass this type of attribute, in which you have to pass numeric values. Cell spacing. Cell spacing means space between two cell, is known as a cell spacing. Cell padding, that means space between cell border and content of a cell. Background color, to specify the background color, we are using BG color attribute. Here we are having a two cell. My first cell value is text 1 and second cell value is text 2. So this space between these two cell is known as a cell space, and this space between text value and cell border is known as a cell padding. Let's take one example of table tag. For creating a table, we are using a table tag. So within a body tag, we are using table tag. Here I'm passing a border value. Always you have to pass border value in numeric form. Now here I want to create my first row using tr tag. Closing tr tag. In between we have to pass values of tr tag. First we are passing a name of columns using th tag. Suppose my first column name is roll number. Complete your first table heading tag. Second heading is name. Close table heading tag. If suppose I am having table in which I am having a two columns, roll number and name. So my first row is created. Here I am created my first row. Now for second row, once again we have to use tr tag, opening and closing tr tag. In between we have to pass the column values using td tag. Td is nothing but table data, to pass the column value, or you can consider as a cell value also. So my first column is roll number, so my first value is roll number 1. Complete table data. I'm having two columns, so I have to pass two values. Second value is for name of student. Suppose student name is Arav Mehta. Close your TD tag. Okay. Now my table is created. Complete your table tag. Complete body section. Now save your file with the use of HTML extension. Now we will run this file into the browser. This is my file table.html. Now you can show ki roll number and name is column name and this is my value. So row number 1 and row number 2. One more example. Here I am specifying the table border. First row I am creating in which I am passing the 3 values. Element 1, element 2 and element 3. For second row, here I am using one special attribute call span. So what is call span? Here value of call span is 2. That means we are merging 2 columns and passing a value element 4. Next value is element 5. In third row, we are using one more special attribute is row span. Here row span value is 2. That means we are merging 2 rows over here. Next row in which I am passing 2 values element 1, element 2. Now complete your table tag. So my output will be like this, in which first row element 1, element 2 and element 3. So here this is my first row in which I am passing first value element 1, element 2, element 3. Okay. In second row we are using call span value, that means we are merging 2 columns. So here 2 columns are merged. Okay. And we are passing value element 4. So element 4. This cell is worked as a single cell because we are merging 2 columns. Okay. And second is element 5. So here is element 5. In next row we are using row span. First value element 1, second value element 2. So first value element 1, second value element 2. Then after we are merging 2 rows. So 2 rows here we are merging and we are passing a single value element 3. So element 3. One more row we are creating in which we are passing a 2 values element 1 and element 2. So here element 1 and element 2. Now division tag. Division tag is used to define a division or a block of statement you can consider section in a HTML document. So it is used to group a block of elements to formatting the style sheet. For example, here I am using division tag. So we have to use div tag with the style tag. Here I am applying formatting to particular style. This is my block of statements. My first statement is heading statement. Second statement of division tag, because division tag is a group of block statements. Okay, so this is my more than one statements are grouped. Complete division tag. So output will be like this. This is my heading tag and this is my simple statement. Here we are applying style color only. Color is equal to red. So we will get output like this in red color. Now some attributes of division tag. First attribute is align. To specify the alignment, we are using align attribute. Style attribute. To specify formatting for the style sheet, we are using this type of attribute. ID attribute is used to uniquely identify the particular division or section in a web page. class attribute is very similar to the ID attribute. It specifies the one or more classes names for the element. Now here we will see the use of ID attribute. So ID attribute is used to uniquely identify any element within the HTML web page. For creating a ID, we are using a hash sign. This sign we are using for creating a ID. So always your style sheet will be created within a head tag using style tag. So within a head tag, we are creating our style sheet, and here I'm using ID. So for creating a ID, we have to use a hash sign. My ID is user defined ID name, and here I'm passing a number of properties. Complete your style tag, complete your head tag. So here in previous example we are creating a style sheet, and in this example we are using that particular style sheet into our document. So for creating a style sheet with the ID, so head tag, in between we are using style tag, and we are creating our user defined ID, my ID. Here I am passing number of properties. Complete your head tag. In body tag, number of body statements are there. In first statement, I want to apply ID, which is created earlier. So ID is equal to my ID. Name of ID you have to pass over here. So ID is equal to my ID, your statement number 2, complete your body tag, complete your HTML document. So you will get output like this. So here we are applying ID on welcome to VPMP heading only. Okay, so all the properties are applied in this statement, welcome to VPMP. Now class attribute, it is very similar to the ID attribute. And it specifies one or more class names for the element. For creating a class, we are using a dot prefix. Within a head tag, we are creating a style sheet in which we are creating a class name. For creating a class, we are using dot prefix. Pass user defined class name. Suppose I'm passing my class name as a my class. And here apply your number of formatting properties. Close your style sheet. Head tag is closed. Now example. This is an example of creation of class. And here we are using a class in body section. So in body section, we are applying a class in welcome to VPMP. So for applying a class, we have to use class is equal to name of class. Here my class is created. So you have to pass the same name, my class. So all the properties of my class will be applied in this statement, welcome to VPMP. Now special characters in HTML. So many special symbols are available on keyboard, like a less than, greater than, ampersand, semicolon, etc. But we cannot directly write it in our HTML web page. For that, we have to use a special entity names. So this type of characters are known as a special character. For example, key, a copyright symbol. So we cannot directly write the copyright symbol. For that, we have to use particular entity name like ampersand copy. And we will get output like this. This is the symbol of copyright. Some more special characters with the entity name. Less than, greater than, ampersand, left arrow, right arrow, and here all are the entity names. Thank you so much.